Today we are going to learn next topics, resonant antenna and non-resonant antenna. Then first topic, resonant antenna. What is the resonant antenna? A resonant antenna is a transmission line, the length of which is exactly equal to multiples of half wavelength, that is lambda by 2, and it is open to both ends. It is called a resonant antenna. So the length of the resonant antenna can be lambda by 2, lambda, 3 lambda by 2, etc. The radiation pattern of lambda by 2 dipole resonant antenna is typically to 8 shape. It is a number shape. Then second is the non-resonant antenna. The non-resonant antenna, the length of this antenna is not equal to the exact multiple of lambda by 2. This is the definition of non-resonant antenna. The non-resonant antenna is the one on which the standing wave is not present. The waves travel in only in the forward direction is called non-resonant antenna. The standing waves are absent because these antenna are terminated in the correct impedance in which the avoid of reflections. Then demerits of the non-resonant antenna, it is the low gain of low efficiency due to the power of dissipation in the termination, and they occupy of the more space of the non-resonating antenna. Then the next topic is the radiation mechanisms and the evaluation of dipole antenna. Then the radiation mechanisms is the one end of generator, that is the point at open circuit, and the all incident energy must ideally be reflected back, but the practically a small portion of electromagnetic energy except from the system is get radiated. That means the voltage of is the forward and reverse traveling waves. It is a combined to form a standing wave pattern on the line. The voltage antinode is seen at the open circuited load end, and antinode means a voltage or current maxima. The radiation mechanisms can be occurs in the line of forces traveling towards the open circuit must undergo a complete phases reversal. They occupy the point to open circuit. However, all the thermal not be able to this as they passes the equivalent to mechanism insertion. Therefore, same of except the percentage of the amount of energy radiated at the amount of energy, the total energy is very small. This is the two reasons. First is the mismatch between transmission line and the surrounding space, which now acts as the load. Then second one is the two wires are loses to each other. The radiation from one tip will be cancelled to the radiation. That means the other one this because they are opposite polarities and the distance between them is too small as compared to the wavelength. And to increase the amount of radiated power, the open circuit must be enclosed by the spreading of the two wires as the radiated signals. Then arrangement of the coupling between the line transmission, free space is improved and the tips have gone away from the each other. Then the radiation efficiency will be increased further if the two conductors of the transmission line are bent so as them in the same line, that is the rod or wire. The electric and magnetic fields are fully coupled to the surrounding space and the radiational increases, it is maximum. This type of radiator is called as dipole. When the total length of two conductors is half wavelength, it is called half wave dipole, and the radiation further increases. Then next point is the microwave antenna. What is the microwave antenna? The microwave antenna, the frequency band from 1 hertz to 100 gigahertz is called microwave frequency. The antenna operating in this frequency band is called as the microwave antenna. The microwave antenna are exposed to the highly directional. The physical first is the physical dimension. The physical dimensions of the antenna should be many wavelength so as the have high gain. Second is the microwave frequencies. At the microwave frequencies, at the wavelength is very small, and so the physical dimensions of microwave antenna are very small. That means the microwave antenna are very small. Next is the microwave antenna. The microwave antenna are used for microwave communications, which is essentially point-to-point type. At the high frequency, the performance of active device goes to is the maximum output power decreases and the device noise increases. It can be proved that all these problems can be started out of if we have high gain directional antenna. Then requirements of microwave antenna, they should be highly directions and the gain of should be high of the microwave antenna. Then the next topic is the directional of high frequency antenna. Then what is the definition of dipole array? The dipole array, it is the radiation system which consists of grouped radiators or elements. It is called dipole array. These elements are placed close together so that they will remain within each other induction numbers. So they are interact with each other and parts produce the radiation pattern. The gain of such a structure is generally higher than the antenna, and it is possible to obtain omnidirectional pattern is the horizontal plane by using the dipole array. The such array is generally used for TV broadcastings. The parasitic elements and driven elements, the radiating elements is connected to the output of the transmitter and as the driven to the element. The element which are not connected to the transmitter output is called as the parasitic element. The parasitic element are directions or reflectors. Those which are longer than the driver elements are called as the reflectors, where which are shorter than the driven element is called as the directors. Then the second topic is the types of array. There are basic types of array. It is the turnstile array, broadside array, end fire array. Then next point is the selection of feed point. The selection of feed point, the half wave dipole are generally fed by connecting the generator and the generator at the center. Then, but it is not always true. The important factor which is decide to the selection of feed point are as follow. There the feed points of the selections, first of all, antenna impedance, second one feed point impedance, and third voltage and current feedbacks. Then this type of antenna is the selection of directional high frequencies antenna, dipole array, and the types of array. Then the next point is the Aggie antenna or Aggie UDA antenna. Aggie antenna is the antenna that is the sometimes it is also called the a group of dipole antenna, or it is also called driven element, one or more parasitic elements. The all these elements, like as parasitic elements, driven elements, these elements are arranged the collinearly and close together as the antenna. The Aggie antenna can be used as a transmitting or receiving antenna. When used as a transmitting antenna, the source is connected to the dipole, is called driven element, and the parasitic elements are not connected electrically anywhere the radiational pattern. The radiation pattern, next point is the radiation pattern. The radiation pattern of the Aggie antenna, we shows that the Aggie antenna is a directional antenna. The radiational pattern at the dipole is the figure of 8, like as number, but it is modified by the reflectors and directors. By adjusting the distance between two adjacent directors, it is possible to reduce the back lobe at the radiation of patterns. Generally, only one reflector and many directors are used in this antenna, Aggie UDA antenna, and the length of the directors will be reduced progressively of the regulator pattern of Aggie UDA antenna. Then advantages of the Aggie UDA antenna. The advantages of the Aggie UDA antenna, it is the directional antenna. It has a moderate gain of about 7 dB. It is very compact, large bandwidth. It is can be used in high frequencies. And last one, it is the adjustable front of back ratio. It is adjustable to front to back ratio. And next point, disadvantages of antenna. The disadvantages of antenna, the gain of is not very high. That is, gain is very low. It is need to large number of the antenna. It is not to be used in this antenna. Then applications of Aggie UDA antenna. The Aggie UDA antenna is used in high frequency transmitting antenna. It is also used in higher frequencies at very high frequency as TV receiving antenna. A stock of Aggie antenna can be used as a super gain antenna. Then the next topic is comparison of resonant and non-resonant antenna. The resonant antenna, the first parameter is the definitions. Resonant antenna, it is the transmission line of length is equal to the multiplies of lambda by 2 and open at both the ends. In non-resonant antenna, it is the transmission line whose length is not a multiple of lambda by 2. A resonant antenna multiply by lambda by 2 in the two ends are open, and non-resonant antenna, it is length is not multiplied by 2, lambda by 2. Then the second parameter is terminations. In resonant antenna, the terminations, there are open at both the ends. and non-resonant antenna, these are terminate properly, which is break the antenna. Then third parameter, reflections. Then resonant antenna, it is the standing wave is present. In non-resonant antenna, standing wave is not present, because in short, standing wave is absent. Then the fourth parameter is radiation pattern. Radiation pattern is the resonant antenna. It is a shape of 8, like as number 8. And non-resonant antenna, like as shape, is the unidirectional. This is the comparison of resonant antenna and the non-resonant antenna. Then the next point is propagation of EM waves. EM is electromagnetic waves. It is the type of propagation is decided by the route is taken by signal, the reach signal to reach the receives from the transmitter. The propagation of electromagnetic waves, there are basically three basic paths that can be radiation signal can be taken. Then first is the frequency range. 30 kilohertz is the ground wave propagation. It is used for mega band and up to 3 megahertz it is used in sky wave propagation in the radio transmitter, and it is above 30 megahertz frequency, it is the space wave or line of sight propagation. It is caused by the TV frequency modulation transmissions. There are the three basic paths of the radiation signals. First is the ground wave propagation. It is also called as the surface, along the surface of Earth. Second, sky wave propagation. It is also called as a layer of the iron sphere and back. And third is the space wave propagation. It is called transmitter to receiver in a straight line. Then first we will discuss about the ground wave propagations. Ground wave propagations, the path is followed by the radiated of electromagnetic wave is around the wave of propagations. That means the definitions of the ground wave propagation. The ground wave surface wave leaves the antenna and remains closed to the earth. The ground wave will actually follow the curvature at the earth and therefore can be travel a distance beyond the horizontal distance. Then next is the ground wave propagation is the strongest of the low and medium frequency ranges. The ground wave is the path chosen by the signal when the frequency is between 30 kilohertz to 3 megahertz. The ground wave must be vertically polarized to be prevent short circuit of electrical field component. The electromagnetic waves are said to be vertically polarized if all its electric intensity vectors are vertical and electromagnetic wave are vertically polarized. Then attenuation of ground attenuations. Then the passing over the earth surface, the ground waves induce same current into they lose same energy due to the absorptions. The distance depends on the type of surface, frequency and operation of the transmitted power. The next point is the application of ground waves propagations. in the applications in the AM radio, amplitude modulation radio, broadcasting, operating in the band. Next applications, the very low frequency transmission is used for ship communications such like as the navigation and marine mobile communications. Then last application is the very low frequency transmission is also used for the time and frequency transmission. Then last topic is the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages of the ground wave propagations: if the transmitted power is large enough, the ground wave propagation can be used to communicate between any two points of the world. Then second advantage is the atmospheric conditions do not affect the ground wave propagation too much. Disadvantages of ground wave propagation: limited the range for higher operating frequencies. At low operating frequencies, very fall antenna should be used. This is because the antenna height should be at least. Next, high transmission power is necessary to the cover of equat range can be power to excess of the common things. This is the advantages and disadvantages of the sky wave propagation. Then next second topic is the sky wave propagation. The sky wave propagations cannot be take place above the frequencies of 30 megahertz because the ionosphere cannot reflect back such high frequency and the ground wave dies out near transmitting antenna itself due to the wavefront the earth's teething. This bending or reflecting the signal taking place due to the parasitic elements of the layer is called as the ionosphere. It is also called as the upper atmosphere. The layer of ionosphere and the sky wave propagation is the illustrated. It is the sky wave propagations. Then space wave propagations. The space wave propagations, it is also called line of sight. The sky wave propagations cannot be taken place above the frequencies of 30 megahertz because the ionosphere cannot reflect back such high frequency and the ground antenna itself due to the wavefront teething. Hence, the frequency of 30 megahertz and space wave propagation is used. The space wave propagations, the signal is received to the receiving antenna is not just due to the direct ray coming from the transmitting antenna, but also the reflected ray. The space wave propagation takes place by the wave or direct wave. These waves travel in a straight line directly from the transmitting antenna to the receiving antenna. The direct or space wave are not refracted like sky wave, or do they follow the circular of the earth like the ground waves. Due to this straight line nature of space wave, they will at the point to block due to the curvature of the earth. If the signal is to be received beyond the horizontal, then the receiving antenna must be tall as compared to the space wave propagations. Then applications of the space wave propagations, it is the TV broadcasting, frequency modulation broadcasting, microwave links, satellite communications. Then the last topic of this chapter is the comparison of ground wave propagation, sky wave propagation and space wave propagations. Then first parameters is the frequency range of propagations. Then frequency range in ground wave propagation, it is exist in the range of 30 kilohertz to 30 megahertz. In sky wave propagation, exist in the range of 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz. And in space wave communication, space wave propagations, it is used for the frequency above 30 megahertz. Then the second parameter is uses in ground wave propagations is used in the radio broadcasting microwave range. In sky wave propagation, it is used for radio broadcasting sky wave range. And space wave propagations, it is used for TV broadcasting and the FM broadcasting. Then the third parameter is the polarization. The polarization ground wave propagations are is vertically polarized, and sky wave propagation, it is also vertically polarized, and the space wave propagation is horizontally polarized. And the fourth parameter, service range of this propagation. The service range ground wave is a service range is few hundred. Sky wave propagation is the can be few thousand kilometer, and space wave propagation is not more than 100 kilometer. Then the next point is the application of sky wave propagations in ground wave propagation. In bandwidth is the ratio of the medium, and sky wave propagation, it is the short wave band ratio radio, and space wave propagation, the TV transmission, FM transmission, satellite communications. And then the last topic is the limitations. The ground wave propagation, it is the limited range for the fall antenna. It is required for high transmission power is required. In sky wave propagation, it is the skip distance power loss due to the absorption of energy by the layer of this antenna. And space wave propagations, distance is limited, fading takes place due to the range and fag. Then the fading is the ground wave is and the space wave is not possible, and the fading of the sky wave propagation, it is signal is of the major conceptions of the sky wave propagation.